didn't say Central was one of your first choices.
It was. Okay. I was definitely about to go to Central State. But I knew all their cadences. I've been up there, like a lot of my homies already marched for them. So I would go up to their practices. You know, I knew everything. So I felt like I wanted to learn something else.
Right.
I didn't want to just play the same stuff we was playing in high school and that I already knew how to play.
So was Alabama State your second choice or was it anything between them?
Nah, so I had Central State, Alabama State, Jackson State, and UAPB.
Okay.
Good list. I visited UAPB, and I talked to them. I played leg center. They was like, yeah, we got them, blah, blah, blah. I ended up not going, and I'm glad I didn't, because come to find out, they lied. They had the chest tenders, and I'd have felt stupid playing being on chest tenor. Upright or whatever y'all want to call them or they want to call them. But so Jackson State, I was really considering, but I heard so much about Jackson, like it's so ghetto down there. It's drama down there, you know, on campus, it's violence, you know, and I'm like, me being from Cincinnati, I don't know nobody down there. I ain't trying to go down there and run into drama when I already got my own mess in Cincinnati. I don't want to go to a whole nother city and state with people I don't know and run into that mess. And I went to Alabama State, bro, and it just looked so clean and so together. So, Alabama State it was.
All right. Well, let's switch gears. Getting into the audition process. Oh, my God, go ahead.
Not to mention, Bama State to me had the better all-around band.
Okay.
I feel like, so what was important to me was the drum line, the drum majors, the dance girls, and the band in general. Okay. So Jackson State had dope drum majors, but I felt like their drum line just played a bunch of dance cadences. Their band was live, and their girls was live. I felt like Bama State had dope drum majors, dope drum line, dope dance girls, dope band. Like, they won out for me. They had everything that I needed compared to Jackson State. I mean, I like Jackson, don't get me wrong, but I just didn't want to do all that damn dancing.
Okay. Just to switch gears, getting into the audition process, because back then, you know, we used to have VHS tapes we had to send in for a long time and had to wear a suit, get in front of the snare and the camera. And play your rudiment. So what was that process like for you? And who helped you along that way getting prepared for these auditions?
I actually was working with Brandon Monroe, who marched for Central State.
Okay.
Because prior to that, you know, I played bass drum in high school. So we knew a few rudiments back then, but it was really for us who can hit the damn hardest. Okay. So I wasn't really on rudiments and everything, but my guy, Brandon Monroe, he played snare drum for Central State. He kind of caught me up to par, got me together. So I was all prepared for that. And then Mr. Yates from Taft High School, he was a young band director in the city. He had kind of took me under the wing for the, as far as the, audition process, videotaping, you know, and sending the information in and making sure I got all my paperwork together. So I did that. It was wild, man. The actual auditioning itself, you know, I was expecting to get up there and just hit the bass drum real hard, play a few little rudiments. But, you know, when it was coming to reading the music and all that kind of stuff, I wasn't really up to par on percussion reading. Like I played trumpet in junior high, and you know, so I knew how to read music on that aspect, but not through the percussion.
Right.
Needless to say, I got a decent scholarship, but when I got there, I actually didn't want the scholarship no more. I kind of canceled the scholarship out for the simple fact that the band director at the time, Dr. Bray, used to like to hold the scholarship above your head. And like anything you do that he don't like, he gonna threaten to take your scholarship away.
Right.
So you know, I'm like, yeah, I didn't get enough money anyway to even let that phase me. So I was just like, y'all can just cut that. That way you ain't dangling nothing over me, bro. You're not doing that. Yeah.
Yeah. And, you know, and they do it and they say they try to teach you a lesson as you're coming in. So this is a good tip for all you people who watch it, especially high school seniors, that this is a business. So they're going to use that money and then say, oh, yeah, scholarship will look funny. So the process of did he call your band director as well from your high school to get any recommendations for you?
Yeah, I definitely got recommendations from the band directors at high school, from Woodward and Taft, from Mr. Yates, Mr. W.C. Turner from Woodward High School. I had teacher recommendations, stuff like that. You know, I think a lot of it for me also was I wasn't really on the money like that for me. Okay. I came from a household with my mama and daddy and they both was doing well. So I just like that. They taking care of it. I ain't worried about it. You know what I mean?
Right.
If I knew then what I know now, then I would have been more like trying to get all these different scholarships and all that kind of stuff. But then I kind of was just like, they got it. I ain't tripping.